tour for the governor. I'd like to start out by just making some opening comments. We all know that we've been through, you know, the flood in 15 and Matthew in 16. And I think the reason we come out pretty good on the end is because people were prepared. I cannot encourage and stress strong enough how important it is to be prepared for any type of disaster that could affect our community. One way of knowing how to prepare is knowing what can affect your community. We have in Charleston County, we have our own hurricane guide that you can download off the Charleston County website. And we have some here for the media if you'd like to take some with you. And it has information in here about being prepared, evacuation, sheltering, all that type of stuff. And also the state has a hurricane guide that they publish every year that is also available, that has a lot of information in that also too, also about being prepared. So the key word here is being prepared, okay? Everybody needs to understand the seriousness of these disasters. So at this time, I would like to turn it over to the Honorable Governor Henry McMaster to have a few words.
Thank you. Thank you, Kathy Hayes. And this season, the hurricane season has already started. It started yesterday, and there's nothing we can do about it. If they hit it our way, they go come. So all we can do, as Kathy Hayes has just said, is be prepared. We prepare for the worst and hope for the best. We must. We would encourage everyone to get one of these booklets, to study up, to go online, to understand where the evacuation routes are, to have the sort of supplies they need at home, the batteries, those sorts of things. Be sure to understand what you'd be doing with your pets, and also if an evacuation order is made. Please heed it. We're not going to say that the sky is falling unless it really is falling. This is a great team that we have in the state, and we're all battle-tested people here in this area particularly, and it doesn't get any better. We've got the best people, and we've been through it before, and we're trying to get better and better. We can't do anything to stop the storm, but we can save lives. By understanding being prepared, understanding what's coming, and listening to official channels, not the social networks that may often have very innocent but very wrong information that cause a lot of trouble. Listen to the official networks, official channels, and know where they are, and we'll come out just fine. And now, Kim Stenson, head of the Office of Emergency Management.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you much. One of the things that I wanted to talk about was Kathy's already mentioned the hurricane guide that we publish every year. We push that because it's got a lot of good information about what you need to do before, during, and after a hurricane. And I'm going to talk where it's available here in a few minutes, but just a couple of things that it does talk about. It does have the evacuation zones and routes. It tells you some tips on how to prepare before you leave if you evacuate. Such as turning off your water, gas, and electricity. The governor's already mentioned the pet plan. And you have to have a plan for where you're going if you're going to evacuate. Also, staying connected in terms of situational awareness, and as the governor said, the proper sources, and make sure that you're getting the best information and not just anecdotal information out there from social media. So there's lots of stuff in there. It's available right now. It was published recently in all newspapers from the coast back to the Midlands. So you should have been able to receive it that way. It's also available at all Walgreens statewide, also at all state welcome centers, and is also available at coastal DMV offices. It's always available for download or viewing at SCEMD.org. And SCEMD.org also has a Know Your Zone interactive map that allows you to type in your address and see if you're in the zone, and it'll tell you which zone you're in. So it's pretty neat, and certainly invite people to take a look at that. Also, the website has a lot of other information that will help you not only get ready for a hurricane, but also for other natural disasters similar to what Kathy just talked about. So we'll certainly invite you to take a look at our website and use that as a resource in being prepared for all kinds of natural disasters. And I'll be followed by, yes, sir. Oh, I'll be followed by Captain Woods, the DPS.
Good afternoon, I'm Captain Rob Woods. I'm the Emergency Management Coordinator for the Department of Public Safety. DPS has the lead role in evacuation operations for the state. We spend the first 5 months of the year working with our state and local partners, in particular the South Carolina Department of Transportation, in preparing for hurricane season. We work through all of our plans very carefully. We review those. We do that in each of the coastal conglomerates. And we also do a number of exercises that will culminate on June 7th with our full-scale exercise, in which we'll test all of our reversal plans, highway reversal plans, in particular in Charleston, of course, is the I-26 reversal plan. We prepare, we plan, we exercise in great detail, and we encourage the public as we complete our preparations to prepare in the same way, down to that level of detail. For example, in reference to evacuations in particular, know your route, know what route you need to use. When you're on that route, make sure you stay on that route, because if you deviate, there's no guarantee, given traffic volumes, that you'll be able to reacquire another route. We also want you to go down to the level of detail of ensuring that your car is properly serviced, you have a full tank of gas, you have adequate supplies with you when you leave. Now I'll turn the podium over to Mr. Dick Jenkins from SCDOT.
Thank you. I am Dick Jenkins. I'm a state traffic management engineer and work very closely with Highway Patrol and a lot of other folks on establishing the evacuation routes. He mentioned the reversal of I-26, which is, as he termed it, the crown jewel of reversal in the state. But also be aware that in your area, you may have a route, you will have a route that you're designated to take, and take that route. Don't show up by 26, everybody. Now, before the evacuation might be called, you would have freedom to move about as you wish. But once the evacuation starts, those routes will be the managed routes, not just from a traffic control standpoint, but as far as traffic TCPs go, but from a, we monitor them from volume standpoint, traffic counters, traffic density. A lot of ITS, intelligent transportation devices, are out there, including cameras and chamber message signs that will assist you and us in evaluating what is going on if we need to make a shift. Generally, we're looking to get folks about 100 miles from the coast on these routes so that they're out of harm's way with no question. Other than that, just be prepared, and if you choose to leave early, you can take any route you wish. I'll just reiterate that. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Other comments, Mr. Lee?
Thank you, Governor. It was my first year as mayor. Last year, we had Hurricane Matthew come along. And that hurricane, even though it was reduced in strength right before it hit Charleston, the reason there was not a loss of life in Charleston County was because of the professionalism of the emergency management team that you see before you today, and evidenced by our many other partners in emergency management. I got to tell you, my first time up for a hurricane as mayor, I was so impressed at how well coordinated it was and how everyone worked together and cooperated. And they really are prepared, and they really are professional, and so we should be thankful for their service and how well the business of emergency management has come along. And so I would just echo everyone's remarks that we have to, as citizens, be as prepared as our professionals in order to keep the loss of life and danger to our citizens at a minimum. Thank you, Governor.
Thanks, sir. I appreciate it, Governor. It's always a pleasure to have you here.
Thanks, sir.
This is an occasion that we look forward to every year, even though it's my first year as chairman, John's first year as mayor, Governor's first year as governor. The bottom line is this. When the governor brings his team down here, it gives us another opportunity to interact, to coordinate, and become better prepared. We are prepared. We always are prepared. We are your servants, and we will continue to be your servants. But I just want to thank the governor's team that we brought with him for giving us again the opportunity to refine our plans and to interact to make sure that we think outside the box to even better prepare for emergency occasions. Not just hurricanes. Remember, we're in an earthquake world, and we have something called floods periodically. If I'm not mistaken, there was a tornado one John's Island this year. So, quite frankly, we are involved with all emergencies. This is hurricane season, but that does not take away from the fact that we need to be prepared across the board. Thank you all, Mr. Buck.
Yes,
appreciate you being here.
Any other comments?
I'll take just a moment. From Berkeley's standpoint, we were able to work with Charleston and Dorchester. We worked together as a team. We managed to get through the last event without a loss of life, and we were very happy about that. We worked together not only to prepare, but also to expedite, you know, people's return back to their homes. I would like to thank everyone that participated in this today, because it was a sheer information system to where we were telling about, you know, our kudos and our problems and things that we could work with, not only in the Tri-County area, but statewide. And that kind of information sharing, Governor, I can't thank you enough for that, because that gives us an opportunity to pass along our experience to you and you to us, how we might be able to do things better. And I thank them from not only Berkeley County, but for the entire area. Thank you.
Any questions?
Yeah, is there any questions? We can take a few. The governor has another stop he has to be at, and I think we're getting a little over on his time for leaving, but maybe one or two questions. And I'm going to limit you to two, so first come, first serve. Yes, ma'am.
For the governor, if you could talk about what type of information you're getting from the federal government. So far, the president hasn't nominated a NOAA or FEMA head. Are you concerned at all about that formation of communication?
No, ma'am. I'm confident those decisions will be made, but there are plenty of people in those offices that are highly experienced, and that's not going to be where our problems lie. Whatever problems we have here.
Are you okay to speak to them?
Whatever
sorry.
Problems we have here will be those confronted face to face and will be resolved or avoided by those of us that live here. Kim is.
Sir, you're right on target.
One more question, please. Yes, sir.
Governor, I'm really asking you to restate where long as this is stated, but as far as preparations, everybody caught short by 2015 flood. They were really prepared for that. Even with Matthew last year, it's a really touching call. We were right on the edge of evacuation a few times. Given those kind of situations, what is our level of preparedness? How ready are we?
We're ready. And one reason that we will be ready if it happens again is because we're here today. And there's been much work since the hurricane and since the flood. And there are people involved in making these decisions that have done it for many, many years. I doubt if there's another team in the country that's got the experience that, unfortunately, we've had a lot of experience with these kind of things. But the good news is we've had a lot of experience with these kind of things. And all reports from all quarters from the last hurricane are that our team statewide performed wonderfully well, and that's because of preparation just like this, and I'm confident that we have the team in place to meet any sort of disaster, whether it's a hurricane, a flood, or an earthquake, or anything else. And we just hope we know we will have some at some time. The question is we must be prepared. And we must, although we can't always save the property, we can save the lives. And if people are aware and will follow the proper instructions and take the proper precautions, we ought to come out just fine.
I'm sorry, the governor has to really leave. He has to be in Beaufort County in about 30 minutes. So we have to let him go.